going to tell you a little bit about my personal involvement and some of what we've come together to discuss as a co-housing community. When I visualize my future as an LGBT senior living in Madison, Wisconsin, and aging in place, I imagine residing in a community of like-minded yet diverse individuals and families committed to mutual support and fellowship while we share spaces to congregate, celebrate, recreate, and engage in creative collaboration. I also need a personal, private space, a place of my own to retreat. And as I age, that becomes even more important. In a perfect world, I would live in a walkable neighborhood with a library and a community center, a medical clinic and a grocery store, retail businesses and services, and a coffee shop or restaurant that I could take my friends and entertain my family. I'd like to have easy access to mass transit, parks, and green space. I'd like to have access to the arts, education, and cultural offerings of the city. I'd like to live in a vibrant neighborhood that celebrated diversity and progressive values. What I've described is co-housing at Union Corners, a mixed-use development here on Madison's East Side, a gateway to the city and the state capital. They call this right here the gateway to the city. And there's been a lot of effort and development on this whole East Washington corridor. And this is like the gateway, the beginning of that development. This is a site that has rich history. And John talked a little bit about it, and I think Lou did as well. But it was originally settled by Ho-Chunk people. There are Indian mounds, and John may even know a little bit more about that. There were Indian mounds there. Union soldiers used that as an encampment. That's why it's called Union Corners. It was the French Carbon and Battery Building for years, and that business supported and employed families for years and years. So it has a rich history in this community. After attending a couple of informational meetings presented by John Steines and Carolyn Werner, who's not here tonight, I became interested. After meeting members of the Arboretum Cohousing and touring their community and talking to their community members, I became a convert to living in a community. And when I became a founding member of MESCoH, Madison East Side Cohousing, we began assembling a chosen family and community. Let me read the preliminary vision for MESCoH. Madison East Side Cohousing is a group of individuals seeking to establish, design, and create an intentional community of homes and common spaces on the east side of Madison at Union Corners, based on the cohousing model. Members of MESCoH have expressed interest in such features as building walkable neighborhoods, community gardens, outdoor common areas, and street design featuring traffic calming. And it's interesting, one of the first things developed on this site after the remediation was one of the first roundabouts, although it's a kind of a small one, which is right here, and some of you may have already taken that little drive. MESCoH invites like-minded individuals with shared values and a commitment to participatory decision-making to join us as we develop our vision and mission statement and move forward to create a welcoming and diverse community that is affordable, intergenerational, LGBTQ and senior friendly, and dedicated to preserving the quality of life and vibrancy of our East Side neighborhood. MESCoH has been formed as a not-for-profit corporation. At the core of cohousing, more precisely at the heart of the community, members dream, shape, and determine how and where they want to live, both individually and together. what their shared common spaces will look like, delineate their shared values, and lastly, decide how their home will be managed and maintained. A co-housing community is a family of sorts, a chosen family, one with equal rights and responsibilities. Now, one of the reasons why my fellow co-housing members are here is we've been doing a lot of this work already. We've been meeting regularly, sometimes twice a month for the last year. Behind Lou and behind our co-housing group is a banner that Mary's going to talk a little bit about. She led the exercise at our retreat where we did some brainstorming, some big picture thinking about what we would like to have as part of our community. At the end of this process, at these workshops, we're inviting you to join us and be part of that exercise. But this is some of the fundamental building blocks that we've already determined for our building, which is, will be this Sister West location. Of course, we're gonna need a marketable name, and we're gonna ask for your help to get a nice, sexy, marketable name for us. But the foundation of our community is as follows, and I wanna commend John for having this be part of his vision from the very beginning, to have it be intentionally welcoming, that we want it to be both LGBT and senior friendly, not exclusive, but we want to make it a welcoming community for that. We also have a strong commitment to affordability, and we want to make sure that we do that as a way of having as much diversity in our community as possible. Socioeconomic diversity, racial and ethnic diversity, age diversity. We want people who, like myself, hope to age in place, but also invite young families who may want to join there and start their families, like you heard the story that was shared earlier. We want to minimize our impact on the environment. We want to be good stewards to the land. And we have a desire to live in community and share resources. She was telling a funny story about how her pump for her bicycle pump kind of disappeared. Well, we're hoping to have a resource center where we donate camping gear, games, arts and crafts supplies, things that we are already saying, this is shared resources. Because when you live in community, we don't each need to consume and have all that stuff in our own personal environments. We can live in a smaller space and we can have larger common spaces. We also want to nurture and invest in the neighborhood. We have an investment. Some of our members in MESCoH have either grown up in this neighborhood, had families who have lived or worked in this neighborhood, and we want to make sure that whatever happens here, we have a word about what the outcome will be. So some members of our MESCoH group currently live in the neighborhood and want to remain there. So members of MESCoH have been meeting with co-housing community partners for over a year, including SASE, which is the Schenck Atwood Starkweather Yahara Neighborhood Association, with the Design Coalition, Inc. and Design Coalition Institute. We've really been mentored a lot by ARBCO, the Arboretum Co-Housing. They've invited us into their community. We've had a couple of meals there with them. We've had a couple of tours. A couple of our members went to a consensus workshop to learn how to make decisions together as a group. So they've been very helpful. They've offered to give our group any kind of documents and help that we need to actually expedite this process. We've also been meeting with some co-housing project development consultants who've had roles in some of these other developments, and the project manager and architects from Gorman. So as I mentioned, MESCoH is a not-for-profit corporation. We've elected a board of directors and we meet regularly about twice a month, and we invite the public to any of our meetings. You'll be getting a handout when we sit at your tables, and it gives the vision. It has a small snapshot of what the current although not finalized by any means, of what that triangle is for the cohousing. It has information on how you can get on our listserv and get informed of any meetings, updates on the project, and how to stay in contact with us. You're also going to receive a poster. We're going to have some coffees. Rather than having this be more, I think Design Coalition Institute and Lou have done an excellent job creating, with John Steinis's help, these more technical workshops, getting the people here that you need to talk to about financing, about legal stuff. You're going to meet some of the cohousing founders at Saturday's meeting if you come back to that workshop. We want to create an opportunity for a more casual and formal environment where you can come and have a cup of coffee with us and ask us questions. Ask us questions about why we are committed to cohousing and maybe perhaps what your interest level might be. And you can ask us those kinds of questions of how you make that decision. We're also going to be handing out at the tables that we sit at a survey. I think Sue's group also has a survey. Ours is just really to gauge your interest, your timing on when you might be interested in joining cohousing, and a little bit of ranking your top priorities. What are the things that are going to make the biggest difference to you about living in community? And of course, we're going to ask for your name and contact information so we can stay in touch with you.